Hello, and welcome to this new episode of the Machine Learning Essentials series, where we talk about some fundamental concepts of machine learning in the cloud. I'm Nishant Tucker, and in this video, we'll talk about training ML models at scale. Now, when it comes to machine learning, training is a job that takes an enormous amount of time and resources, as this is the phase where the machine is actually learning from large quantities of data. Now, there are two concepts to understand and optimize for here. One, it's managed versus bring your own compute. And two, the right compute configurations, keeping in mind the intent of the user. Let's look at each of these in a little more detail. Machine learning has evolved over the years with a lot of contributions from the open source communities. As a result, machine learning frameworks and libraries now support multiple compute frameworks, including Dask, Apache Spark, Kubernetes, and many more. When it comes to Azure, the managed compute offerings are based on Azure Batch. This means there are dedicated VMs assigned as compute with network isolation and security protocols that cater to the most stringent of regulatory standards. We'll talk more about managed computes within Azure Machine Learning in a minute. The other compute option is bring your own compute. Why is this needed? Well, great question. Some users might prefer to run their jobs on Apache Spark or Kubernetes clusters. This could be for a variety of reasons. Having idle capacity in existing clusters, preferring specific compute engines over others, standardizing across multi-cloud or hybrid environments, and others. To ensure that such requirements can be met, Azure Machine Learning allows users to attach compute from other Azure services like Azure Databricks, Synapse Analytics, Azure Kubernetes Service, or even Azure HD Insight. This allows users to leverage their choice of compute frameworks to train models in their choice of environments. Here's a pro tip. Only use these attached compute options if you understand these engines really well. Azure Machine Learning can optimize your job to run on managed compute, but relies on you to optimize the bring your own compute options. Now let's talk a little more about the managed compute options. There are two offerings here. One, compute instance, which is a single instance interactive workstation. This is best suited for getting started or dev test type workloads. Compute clusters, which is the second option, is a multi-node distributed cluster for large training jobs. This is best suited for production-level training of complex models on very large datasets. Here, we're just talking about training compute. There are other managed compute offerings for inferencing, which we'll discuss in another episode of the ML Essentials series. Coming back to the training compute, in addition to provisioning these compute environments, with commonly used tools and libraries, Azure also enables admin experiences for enterprise readiness so that these can be managed centrally. Some of these admin experiences are scheduling to automate the provisioning and guaranteeing its availability, creating an on behalf of capabilities, which allow admins to provision on behalf of users to keep deployments in check, quota management, to ensure compute environments do not hog up all the resources. Monitoring to keep track of jobs on these compute environments. Utilization tracking to ensure that compute resources provisioned are not sitting idle. And of course, security. Supporting secure RBAC to sophisticated network isolation. Both compute instances and compute clusters come with a lot of the above admin experiences. Let's dive a little deeper into each of them. First, compute instance. A compute instance is a fully managed cloud-based workstation optimized for your machine learning development environment. It provides the following benefits. One, these enable productivity. It comes pre-installed with Jupyter, JupyterLab, RStudio, and it also integrates seamlessly with Azure Machine Learning notebooks and Visual Studio Code. Second, these are pre-configured for machine learning. so you can save time on setup tasks with pre-configured and up-to-date ML packages, deep learning frameworks, GPU drivers, and many more such aspects. Third, of course, these are secure. Compute instances provide robust management policies and secure networking configurations, such as you can auto-provision these from ARM templates and Azure Machine Learning SDK. You can bring them under Azure role-based access control. You can enable virtual networks for these. You also have SSH policy to enable or disable SSH access, and these come with TLS 1.2 enabled. Another benefit of compute instances is that it is fully customizable. Broad support for Azure VM types, including GPUs and persisted low-level customizations, such as installing packages and drivers, make advanced scenarios a breeze. In general, a compute instance is specific to a single user for the interactive workload, but it can allow batch jobs from other users too, if the owner permits. Next, let's talk about compute cluster. Compute cluster is a managed compute infrastructure that allows you to easily create a single or a multi-node compute environment. A compute cluster can be shared with other users in your workspace. Compute clusters can run jobs in a virtual network environment without requiring enterprises to open up SSH ports. The job executes in a containerized environment and packages your model dependencies in a Docker container. The main purpose of compute clusters is their ability to scale out. The compute cluster scales automatically when a job is submitted, depending on the heuristics of the training job, thereby distributing tasks to individual nodes to be executed in parallel. Now, this applies to both data parallelism, where data is divided into partitions and the number of partitions is roughly equal to or potentially a multiple of the total number of available nodes in the compute cluster, and model parallelism, which we also refer to as network parallelism sometimes, where the model is segmented into different parts that can run concurrently in different nodes, and each one will run on the same data. You can use a compute cluster to distribute training or even a batch inference process across a cluster of CPUs or GPU compute nodes in the cloud. Here's a pro tip. Compute clusters are designed to cater to long-running jobs, and as such can recover from node failures or preempted nodes in the case of low-priority VMs. Thus, always use compute clusters for production-level training jobs. Well, we've discussed a lot of concepts in this video. Let's quickly recap. We first looked at two forms of compute. Managed compute, which comes with a lot of added benefits like security, administration, quota management, etc. And then bring your own compute. This provides the flexibility of compute engines alongside the ability to utilize spare capacity. Within managed computes, we discussed two types. Compute instance for getting started quickly or dev test type workloads, and compute clusters for large distributed production scale training jobs. All these compute environments can support enterprise grade security like RBAC and VNets. To try these, please spin up a free Azure Machine Learning workspace at aka.ms/aml-trial. Also, download a 30-day learning journey from the Data Scientist Resources page at aka.ms/data-scientists. That's all for now. See you in another episode of the Machine Learning Essentials.